Hello, dear friends. Welcome to Kardec Radio, where we are here to nourish our souls. I am Norah, Brazil, the host of this program, Pages of Hope. Another day, another opportunity to keep sending love, to keep emanating peace, harmony, fraternity, and just these messages of hope from within and out through our thoughts, through our words, and our actions, dear friends. So today's program has a beautiful and powerful piece. It's so tiny, but it's so powerful. You know, I'm very, very short, and I would say I'm short, but it gives space to offer more. And so it's like that. Whenever we read short passages, we need to watch out because there's probably so much in there that we can intake out. So let's go ahead and read this together. This is God is Within Us by Carlos Torres Pastorillo in the book Minutes of Wisdom. And this is found in the Spiritus magazine, issue 53. God is within us in all circumstances of life. Whether you are practicing a good action or making a mistake, God is within you. Whether you feel happiness or suffering, God is within you. Try not to forget this truth at any time in your life. God is within you. There it is, dear friends, right? When God is within us, boom. And it doesn't matter what state we're in, right? It's not always the good. That's why we're here. We're practicing to become more refined through every life, through every day, constantly changing, right? We think about it. We're not the same from even 5 minutes ago. So much has happened, our thoughts, etc. So we can imagine this perspective of God being within us. Yes, it's a tiny passage, but it's huge. We're currently studying Andres Luis' books, and we're doing one right in the book. The series that we're on right now is called Workers of the Eternal Life. And there's a passage in this book that's describing a battle that they're having on a spiritual realm. And Andre is in this place titled Casa Transitoria, meaning transient house. It's a mobile house. It moves from different regions. But where they're stationed, they're almost like this ER hospital for souls. Of course, because they are an ER hospital, what kind of vibrations do we expect for there to be out there? Very low. And Andre describes how these beings are so low, but sometimes they'll come to the barrier that they have and say, please help me, please help me. And in one of these occasions, they were going to have like a cleansing of the atmosphere. So as the cleansing was going on, these particular spirits came again to like this magnetic fence, begging, please save me, please save me. And somebody asked, well, how do we know that they're being honest? How do we know that their words are authentic? And Andre's mentor says, look at their aura. If on top we can imagine it's darkness, no matter what comes out of them, we know that they're not genuine. If we see a bright light on top of them, then that right there shows to us that they are willing to change. And this is absolutely beautiful because when we have that God within us, as we are developing it, that light begins to shine, right? It's not that the other beings are not, right? It's just that it's not developed to the potential that we have. And so when we think about God is within us, we can safely say that as we are praying, as we are thinking good thoughts, as we are loving, we are seeing with different eyes. There's this beautiful book by Don Miguel Ruiz, The Mastery of Love, and a chapter entitled Seeing with the Eyes of Love, page 158. There's this beautiful piece for us to think about, right? Because in essence, for us to connect to ourselves and to others, we need to have those eyes that are willing to see that, not just the darkness, but to see the progress, right? Because even when we are not perfect, we are still refining ourselves. there are seeds that are being planted, and there's a little bit of more light shining through. So when we have these eyes of love, it becomes like a different world. Like we see things different, like maybe in radio waves, for instance. If we look at the wavelengths, right? We have different wavelengths, different ways that we can see visible light. We can see beyond that range. If you have eyes of love, you just see love wherever you go. The trees are made with love. The animals are made with love. The water is made with love. When you perceive with the eyes of love, you can connect your will with the will of another dreamer. And the dream becomes one. When you perceive with love, you become one with the birds, with nature, with a person, with everything. Then you can see with the eyes of an ego or transform into any kind of life. With your love, you connect with the ego and you become the wings and you become the rain or the clouds. But to do this, you need to clean the mind of fear and perceive with eyes of love. You have to develop your will until it is so strange that it can hook the other will and become one will. Then you have wings to fly. Or being the wind, you can come here, you can go there, you can push away the clouds, and the sun is shining. This is the power of love. And these are these beautiful eyes, friends, that we start to see that God within us, right? Friends, this is today's lesson, hoping that we stay in that vibration. We're going to sing a very special song, the prayer of St. Francis of Assisi, because the current times, to continue seeing this God within us and see it in others, see it in the world, despite any darkness, we still need to try. Kind of like that excerpt from Andre, they still needed to connect and try, right? Let's sing in a prayer form. Let us grab the guitar. All right, dear friends. Let us sing this beautiful song, allowing this God within us to see with the eyes of love all around us. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Today's powerful message, reminding ourselves God is within us. I see with eyes of love, and I see that light in everyone. Even in the darkest places, there is God's light. Dear friends, don't forget to tune in to other programs here at Kardec Radio, where we're always, always nourishing ourselves. Until next week, same place, same time. Bye-bye.